Let us pray. Lift up your two hands because you want to talk to God now. Lift up your two hands. Say, Father,
Father,
I have. Say, I have. Only this opportunity
to live on earth.
Help me today
to
secure eternity.
Help me today
to secure my tomorrow.
Release your spirit
upon my mind.
Help me, Lord,
to take
good decisions.
Say amen.
Holy Spirit, instruct our hearts.
If you are removed from us, nothing will be left. Instruct us today. Drive away folly from our hearts. Bring abundance of wisdom to us. Let it well up in us. Let it begin to overflow. As we hear from you today, let there be true transformation. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Clap your hands for Jesus as you have your seat. The theme, the topic is a secured tomorrow. Can you please do me a favor? Ask your neighbor, neighbor,
neighbor,
is your tomorrow secured? Turn to the other side. Ask the next neighbor close to you. Neighbor,
neighbor,
how is your tomorrow?
Is it
secured? What is the reply? If your tomorrow is secure, wave your hands and shout hallelujah. Is there anybody who does not have a secure tomorrow here? If you are here, can you wave your hands? If your tomorrow is not secured, if it is not secured, me, I disagree with all of us here. As we go through this talk today, we will see that maybe one or two persons sitting down here do not have secure tomorrow. Flip the pages of your Bibles to Genesis chapter 15. Genesis 15. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, Fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus? And Abram said, Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in my house is mine heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thy own bowels shall be thine heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now toward the heaven and tell the stars, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of all of the Chaldees to give thee this land to inherit it. And he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? And he said unto him, Take me an heifer of 3 years old and a she goat of 3 years. 3 years old and a ram of 3 years old and a turtle dove and a pigeon. And he took unto him all these and divided them in the midst and laid each piece one against. This is the story of Abraham. Everything we read in this passage and also the few following verses we have not read talks about the tomorrow of Abraham. God told him, Abraham, I know you are already old. Abraham, I know you are already old. And today I have come to tell you that I am your shield. I am your exceeding great reward. It doesn't matter what your today is, there is something me, God, I am looking up to. I am looking at your tomorrow. I care very less about today, but my attention is focused on your tomorrow. So when you cry sometimes and say, God, I have no child, me, I am already living in your tomorrow. All I am saying is that, Abraham, run, meet up. I am waiting for you here. When Jesus was in the garden and was praying to God, God, take this cup away from me. God was already looking at Jesus triumphing. God did not come to remove the cup, but what he did was, he sent an angel and strengthened Jesus. May God give you strength. To overcome the trials of now. So that you can harvest tomorrow. Today's message goes mainly to the youth, because let me say 80% of us here may be youths. Am I correct? Who are the owners of tomorrow? Our mothers? Our fathers? Who? The youths and the children. We are the owners of tomorrow. Today has been handed over to us, and we are going to possess tomorrow. And tomorrow is not far from today, because tomorrow is in the womb of today. Have you not heard that tomorrow is pregnant? Tomorrow is pregnant. The womb of tomorrow is in today. So somebody can just wake up and decide to abort tomorrow, because the pregnancy of tomorrow is in the womb of today. You can abort it, and then when you go to tomorrow, you discover that there is no miracle to give birth to, because it has already been aborted. Our parents are handing over to us now, and some of the things they are handing over to us, they are not so pleasant. There are youths who abort the grandfather, the grandmother, the mother, the father, and they are still children, because they carry the whole burden of the family. Why is it like that? Because the parents did not prepare enough foundation for them. If you are in this class of persons, you have more than enough to do. If your tomorrow must be secured, the whole of foundation you are given, you must make sure you fill it up first before you start building. When I look around and look at our society, when I look closely and look at our society, I see boys and girls who have no foundation. I see many boys and girls, they have no foundation, but if you see them, you will say, this is the angel of God. You will be tempted to ask whether Buhari or Jonathan is from Isoko or Urobo. Because you see some youths, you will think their parents, the father, is the president of this country. And when they talk like a child of a president. But when you see where they come from, instead of you to pity them, you begin to pity yourself. Because even if you pity them, it does not remove anything or add anything to their life. Pikin, when his mama and his papa don't die, you know why they get sense? If he's true, go meet his friend. If friend mama call the advice, the pikin say, advice the friend say, my pikin, put eye for grand, no, this world no easy, oh. The pikin, when they see they wear pampers, he no go here and well. But the one when his mama and his papa don't die, so that one knows that life is not easy. It's just a repetition of what he is passing through. So that one will quickly pick advice and adjust. Praise the Lord. And when God had this encounter with Abraham, God told Abraham, Abraham, I am your exceeding great reward. I am your reward. You left your father's land and you followed me. Even up till now, I have not given you the promised child. I told you the day I called you that through you, all nations of the earth shall be blessed. I know the promise I have made to you. I am your reward. Keep following me. And Abraham said, God, how do I know that you are going to give me this land? Because I'm running close to 100 already. And by your calculation, I shouldn't live more than 70, 80, and then by the time I get to 100, I will know I'm getting expired. So you are telling me you are going to give me this land? How? Please, Lord, explain to me that you are going to give me this particular land. And God gave a very simple instruction. In the matter of securing tomorrow, instructions are very, very important. I remember the day Esther was leaving the house of his uncle. The uncle told Esther, "Esther, you know we are foreigners here." Esther said, "Yes, daddy." "As you go to that place, do not reveal your identity." It's a very difficult task, but simple. The man, that what the uncle was saying is that, Mordecai was saying is that, do not tell your husband where you came from. Is it possible? Eh? Especially when love has gain access into the brain and decide to occupy the best seat in your brain. Every normal human being does not need a question before you open up. Darling, do you even know where I came from? He said, "No, sorry, you've not even told me. You know I'm busy. I've not even bothered to ask you." Do not reveal it. And there was something Esther did too. She kept herself. She knew the scripture. She knew what God demanded from every Israelite, and she kept herself. So the night it came to the turn of Esther to visit the king met with Esther and discovered that she was beautiful outside, and inside she was still beautiful. Praise the Lord. Can you say hallelujah to that? Do we have beautiful girls in this house? If you are a beautiful girl in the house, wave your hands and shout hallelujah. Do we have handsome men in this house, handsome youths? Do we have them in this house? I can't see your hands. My hand is up already. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah. If it had been some of us, and the king sees us, say, with the artificial eyelash, with all the different color of the Mary Kay and the Papa Kay, and then the king takes us to a one night with the king would have been disappointed, because outside, the whole of the beauty is outside. There is nothing inside again. Yesterday, I did a little survey. I was sitting down there, and then somebody came up to me and said, "Look at the way that girl covered her hair. Everywhere is exposed." So my mind was, what is this world turning into? I started looking at the mamas, our good mommies in the house. I looked at one, her hair was well covered. I looked at another one. I looked at youths. I said, this is another generation. In those days, we used to have inner beauty. Today, it is gone. Even in the day, carry torchlight. Tell NEPA. NEPA, we still have NEPA, I hope you know. Eh? Forget the change of name, they are the same. We still have NEPA. Tell NEPA to own electricity and begin to look for inner beauty you will not see. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. So, Esther kept to the instructions. Now look at what God told Abraham. He said, take an heifer of 3 years old, and a she-goat of 3 years, and a ram of 3 years, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. Abraham obeyed God. But, you know, when the devil knows you are on track, he will come to keep you off track. Where did those birds, the birds that came, the vultures, where did they come from? Sacrifice of God, they were not afraid. They came and decided to feed on those sacrifices. But Abraham was wise. He took sticks. He said, this one, God said he's going to meet with me today. And you are here to destroy the covenant. You are here to destroy the sacrifices. Abraham labored and decided to fight them. He drove them away. When it comes to securing tomorrow, the moment you grow up, do not tell yourself we are here to enjoy. We are not in this world to enjoy. We are here to fight. If you read Revelation, it says, to him that overcome, to him that overcome, to him that overcome will I give. Why is it not that? To him that enjoy it. We are here to fight. It is better for you to understand this now than for you to think, see, when paradise became lost, enjoyment was lost. Do you know where the tree of life is now? Go to Revelation 22. You will see the tree of life there. God gathered the tree of life and a flaming sword was moving up and down. After that moment, God uprooted that tree and took it to heaven. Because I believe 100% that God uprooted the tree, because the tree, even there is life in the leaves. Life is in every part of that tree. Some of the things God created, he covered them. See, today we are still discovering new minerals in the soil. We are still discovering them. Some of the things God created, we can't get them again. So when you appear in this earth and you think you are here to drink, you are here to smoke, you are here to move up and down, see, evil days are coming. Ask a man of 80 years old to run. Those who used to wear labu in those days and wear pencil in those days, those who used to wear sabato in those days, ask them to wear them now. Life is in phases. Life is in stages. If you do not understand the time and you think life is all about yeah, you fail. I have not seen a man of 80 years putting on a earring. Have you seen? 80 years old, wearing a earring. They will tell you, my pikin, wait till those words all pass. Buy ice cream. Travel, go London, may you buy ice cream. Call, give your grandmother. The teeth which they manage, you can't buy ice cream. Come give her joy. What do you define? You go see her. Abraham chased away the birds. I said, you can't come near here. God said he's going to meet with me, and anything that must stop God from meeting with me is my enemy. Divine instructions are very, very important. When God gives instructions, let us abide. See, it doesn't matter through whom the instruction comes. Because some of us, we look at the person talking and said, who is this? How many cars has he? You know, not say donkey talk, donkey. You know, hear him. Say, somebody where they stubborn to God, you know what you hear from God. Now God say, animal, I go talk to you. And when the animal talk, you know, even shock self because his heart don't already strong. Now he answered the animal back. May that not be our portion in Jesus' name. If we don't reach where God won't use animals talk to us, person when don't cross the boundary of life, he don't enter the other side. Even if you have asked, I mean, not the year again. Tomorrow is bigger than today. Tell your neighbor, tomorrow is bigger than today. When we think life is about now, here, and here, we will miss it. Life is about tomorrow. And God said, do not worry about this tomorrow, but prepare for it. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 34, God gave us instruction. He said, you see this tomorrow? It is already in my hand. I am already in tomorrow, so do not worry. Do not worry about tomorrow. That tomorrow has enough problems of itself. Do not worry and begin to add to the problems of tomorrow. Some of us, we know how to package our problems instead of facing them now. We package them very well and take them to tomorrow. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 to 11 talks about the ant. Say, the ant is very wise. It knows how to secure itself against tomorrow. The ant does not move in the rainy season. So all the food it will eat throughout the rainy season, it will prepare them and hide them. When the sun is up, you see them very busy up and down. Busy. A youth that can brush his teeth when it is already 10 a.m. What kind of youth is that? It's 10 already. It is then you woke up, you are stretching yourself and cracking your bones. And Maria, I better bring a cup of water for me, make I just stay for this mouth brush. When your mates, they don't sleep in the night, you are spent the whole night sleeping and snoring. You are also wasting the money that you're supposed to spend in your workplace. Some of us, all the good things God has for us tomorrow, we have traveled to tomorrow, imported them from tomorrow, and we are spending them today. Won't it be papa and mama walking stick when they don't old? Eh? No, be children. Won't it be your walking stick? When God brought us to life, we had no hands, we had no legs. And then a time came, we had four legs at once. We walk,
with our two legs and our two hands. Another time came, another stage came. We had to walk with two legs alone, the way I'm doing now. Another time is coming. You walk with how many legs? Three. And even the walking stick will not be enough. You still need a human support who will hold you and say, Mama, look grand, oh, stone dead there, oh, no match, I'm not kick him, oh, Mama, I'm not go fit carry you if you fall.
May God help us today. Is that prayer for you?
I say, may God help you today. There is something so fascinating about the days of youth.
Do we have youth in this house?
These are the days of your strength. It is the days of my strength. But there are two things we must understand about youthful days. The days of youth, they are the days that every girl and every boy wants to take control. And in course of taking control, you see them preferring enjoyment to work. So also the days of youth, these are the days we're supposed to lay our foundation. I don't know the person that made this statement. If I had known this person, I would have given the person an award. That a fool at 40 is a fool for forever. If you are 41, are you still a youth? That means as at the time of your youth, if you fail to prepare foundations for yourself, you have failed. When I started, I asked a very sensitive question, that how many of us have secured tomorrow's here? And I saw hands lifted up. Now, let's analyze it. You may be John or James sitting down here. You may be maybe Maria or Titi sitting down here. You are already 20, 25, 30, 35. You are not a graduate. Do we have people like that in this house? Do we have people who are between 20 and 35 who are not graduates? And when I mean graduates, I mean people who cannot speak well and write well. Well, it's just a condition, eh? It's no big deal. Then do we have people who are not graduates, they didn't go to school well, and they have no skill, they have no handwork. Do we have them? Answer me, do we have them? No education? Education is zero. Skills? Zero. No trade. No trade. You have no business you are running that fetches you money. Nothing like that. The only thing where you know, say, God help us. Raise your two hands, may you say, God help us.
God help us.
There are girls who are so good in bed, and that is the only skill some people know. I'm not lying. I am not lying. You know very deep in your heart that I'm saying the truth. Cook or you don't know how to cook. Even to wash. How will you wash when you have nails? You and Lucifer, they do competition. You have nothing to eat, but you cannot even scrape your own nails. You will look for 200 naira to give to somebody who will use one razor, one blade to scrape from jackpot to Okere, and you will sit and say, Mala, don't cut my leg, go. And you are telling stories as you ishigom. Don't worry, they will not cut your leg. But in case they break your skin, only one word they will tell you, sorry. And because of that, we have people who don't have secured tomorrow again. What will it cost you? Even if you don't want to do it, what will it cost you to buy your own materials? And say, Aboki, come, don't use your own. This is your public one. Use. Do people with HIV use those things? Or do you think it's only through sexual means that you get HIV virus? No. Blood contact, whether direct or indirect blood contact. Because of laziness of 3 minutes, you can get HIV, buy HIV for free. And then you spend the whole of your lifetime treating HIV that has no cure. I have seen boys who will go to the marketplace and beg for money. I told one of them, I said, Mr. Man, I want to give you a job. Stop begging me for money. Every day you meet me, oh God, help me, help me, help me. I said, I have a job I want to give to you. And a woman made a statement. He said, this one will not agree to work. He has already employed himself. A time will come when that same person will not have enough strength to stand for 30 minutes and beg. And right before my very eyes, a woman was signaling me and said, brother, if you have a job, I have children. There was a day, a cousin of mine called me from Abuja that she was coming with two children, that she entered road late. I had to leave my house because she's not familiar with worry. I had to leave my house around 11 o'clock to go and pick her in a fruit. And when I entered worry, I saw both nonsense and rubbish. The same people we call, who will say, let me go and take prayers. Over the weekends, they take rubbish. And weekdays, they come and use prayers to flush them away. And I ask myself, what tomorrow has this once? What will somebody that God has given strength will be doing at 12 a.m. outside? You are jumping and dancing as though that will not pay you 5 naira. You can go out even on Sunday and go and watch football. You sit for 1 hour, listen to the football, listen to the watch the commentary and everything, and you still engage yourself in betting. It does not end in betting. After betting, you argue. Now my club, nice Abi play pass. Until you see white hair rushing out of your head, you will not know you are old. If there had been any means for me to escape youthful age, I would have done that. I took life serious while I was still young. There was a day I was crying and my mother was laughing at me. And she said, Hosanna, why are you crying? I said, Mama, this life is difficult. I was in primary school. I cried. There was a day I asked my brother, I said, if you cause trouble today, do you have anybody that will give you 50,000 naira cash? He said, no. I said, so be careful. Now, when you never enter Okere, now me, they help you. If you not agree that help, you can't squeeze yourself past Okere prison gates. I don't forget you be that. Me, the only remembrance, I go pray for you, I go send people come preach, give you. After you don't satisfy man for bed, you not go satisfy him for table, you not go use your own manners, character. Eh? Now, character that they relate with mother-in-law. Mother-in-law not be human being. Who go born Pekin? Pekin, when you carry for 9 months, he don't reach when he go live better life. He carry one Delilah put for house, you go happy? While your son was growing up, while your daughter was growing up, you had plans for this person. Just of a sudden, somebody with empty brain came into his life. All the person can talk is, what are we going to use to celebrate Easter? We what kind of fashion? But now kiss the rain now. That is all you know. Mother-in-law, go they happy. Father-in-law, go they happy. May God help us today. Youths, they have the tendency of living a carefree life. They want to take directives from themselves. They will tell you, Mama, I not be small picking again, no. Let me tell you one truth. Me, I have not enjoyed my youthful days. At the age of 17, when I looked at my family and looked at my foundation, my family background, I decided to become a farmer. At the age of 17 years old, if I tell you I know how to fry garri, will you believe? Throughout my secondary school, I planted cassava, I harvested, and there is something I did. No friends. Nobody should come and confuse me. All friends, you are hereby sacked. Don't come and confuse me. I know where I'm going to. Some of you, you don't have principles. Anybody that comes along your way, she got, he said, Mary, I was just coming to you. He said, where did they go before? May I just follow you, Mary? You are aimless. Your friend is aimless. Don't bring anyhow people into your life. If your tomorrow must be secure, move with like-minded human beings. The days of youth, they are the days your brain will tell you you need enjoyment. A time came in my life, I had to take life hot. That life is a battle, and I can't. When I discovered that nobody could come out of my family to help me, let me tell you one big truth. It's bitter. I'm not ashamed to say it. Nobody in my family has given me 20,000 naira anything. I see people come with bags of complaint and say, man of God, my family, things are not working hard, things are not. Look at St. Andrew's Hospital here. You see one big forest, One big forest there. If you plant ugu in that place, the ugu will grow mad. We are living in a country where they import toothpick from China. The toothpick, after you eat it, mama puts chop. The toothpick you use, Many of them are from China.
We carry all our money abroad.
Meanwhile, before your very eyes, some people are looking for waterproof. They are using them in manufacturing bags.
It was announced in this church that there is a training on skills, personal skills.
I came and I peeped. I saw only few persons here.
But if they say, we want to give out money, you will see people who will fill the whole of this hall.
Some people will even go and manufacture identity cards. We are cathedral members.
Give them the money.
Now then you go no say your shield are old.
Now then you go no say, tis the rain for market.
If we must have a secured tomorrow.
There are things we must forget about today. Early this morning, I was doing some research and I found an astounding truth. A research work which says that half of boys, they openly confess that they could sleep with a girl without having any plan or commitment for marriage. Half.
So what I am saying now is this. If we have 2,000 boys in this house, 1,000 are ready to dribble and become Maradonas in the midst of girls. And they are not ready to marry them.
And we have girls who are ready to supply them. All things you need, I hereby give to you. And our parents are not helping issues. I asked a woman who complained to me that a child is running out of home. I said, okay, mommy, at this age, your daughter can run out of home and spend 1 week, 5 days outside in the house of a boy. If the boy happens to say, I want to marry this your daughter, will you give her out?
She said, no, I want me my daughter go to school. I want me that.
Daughter, where boy don't sink for the head.
I told her, you are about losing 3 things at the same time. If you don't start, it's easy to stop. Answer me, if you don't start, it's easy to stop.
Who go marry you when you don't waste all the oil where God give you? The oil, today you are in Jack Barrett. Tomorrow, honey, it's been a while I see you. I want to come to Port Harcourt. You can travel from here to Port Harcourt.
No business idea is just to sleep with 1 year boy and catch money and come back home.
I was coming from Benin and a girl was telling the parents, he said, mommy, I am going for a church program. Before we got to the junction, she called the boyfriend to come and pick her.
Say, so, you know, I'm not so familiar with worry. Come and pick me.
See, many of these boys, if you give them anything, they will take. But give them money and say, take this money, go and pay my bride price.
It's not your money. I am the woman. I am giving you this money. Only take.
We have spent 8 years together. Go and pay my bride price.
Story.
Now then the boy go tell you, say your face no smooth. Well, say in America. Now you take the cover up. Be wise. I told a girl. When you see a girl, a virgin, the breast is well okay.
He never carry any loads.
You go leave that one, go marry the one. When any type of hand, even hand where get leprosy don't hold. By the time you are 60 years old, you will pass and nobody will look back again. That time the oil don't finish. One of our mommy said, I gave birth to my first child when I was 11 years old. And some people said, she got married, they paid her bride price, and she got married as a virgin at 11 years. You may have your own judgment, but I have a lesson. That one is better than somebody whose list of boys is running up to 500, and he has nothing, that one has nothing to show for it that this is my husband. And Jesus said, you have married 5 men before, and the one you have now, is not even your husband.
Praise the Lord. No time.
Okay, listen. Papa and mama will sit down with the ear. My pikin not the ear word. Do we have men in this house who do not take care of their wives? You say you are old, your gratuity, nobody knows how you spent it. You are old, but you know how to connect the money and hide it from one old coat to another. Your wife will not see it. Your children, they are moving about. God will prolong your life. If you are here, you will not die prematurely. You will get old and you will stay to 100 years. And you will reap the area boys you have succeeded in sowing. How many men take pain to pay their children's school fees? The day my father died, I could not cry. Because I didn't know whether the mathematics was plus or minus. We have parents like that here. But my destiny is in the hand of God. If I forget everything and follow Him, He will never fail me. If you are here, you have forgotten everything. You are following God. God must surprise you. Let's be on our feet. Lift up your right hand. Now, our hand of authority be this. After God created man, He said, go and subdue, have dominion. With this hand, we're supposed to make commands. But we have today, we have people today who use this same hand they're supposed to use in making command in begging. Bros, 20 cards. Bros, give me sky. Say, oh Lord, my Father. May this my hand be empowered to give command. Say, my Father, my Father. This my hand. We not beg. Say amen.
Amen.
50 naira won't stop me from writing exam. I call say make I go beg one of my uncle. I call carry bicycle. I reach road, the chain of the bicycle can't even cut. As I dey enter compound, when I was staying with my auntie, I call begin to cry. I say, now life, now like this life be. And I told myself, I am not going to beg anybody for money in my life again. If it is God's work, you want to raise money for God's work, beautiful, but personal use, me. May God help me to continue not to do it. My God, I serve, shall supply all my needs according to His riches in glory. If God cannot help me, no man can help me. Lift up your right hand. Say, oh Lord, my Father.
Oh Lord, my Father.
Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Any vulture.
Any bed of prayer.
Where they eat my sacrifice.
Of our agreement.
Any power.
Where they destroy.
Our covenant meeting point. Say, oh my Father,
destroy that power.
Say, your power,
catch fire.
God not create me, say, make I beg. I'm a giver. And from beg, some don't beg or cutting people, that they take your glory. Each time that their star they go down, they go give you money, they go renew their star. Your two hands up, please. You go talk to God, say, God, this my hand must be useful. Me, I be giver or I be giver. I not go be beggar for my life. Talk to God briefly. I am not a beggar. I must make it in life. It doesn't matter what happens. Round up your prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, thank you for your word. Even upon all this one, we are saying, if we do not carry you along, we will fail. Because it is not by power, it is never by might, it is by your spirit. If we carry you along, we will succeed. For you said, without me, you can do nothing. Those who don't have Jesus, as you hear this message and you make up your mind, and you accept Jesus into your life, may your destiny change for the better. No monitoring demon will steal the word of God from you.
Thank you, Father. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.